Good morning, good evening, everyone. I am Dr. Devansh Chakraborty from PGIMS Rotor, and I shall be presenting radiological evaluation of stomach in a pictorial review. The stomach is involved in a myriad of pathologies ranging from benign to malignant, ranging from peptic ulcers, portal gastropathy, hypertrophic pulmonary sclerosis, and medical conditions like carcinoma, lymphoma. And the common symptoms of stomach pathology are localized or diffuse abdominal pain, swelling or distension of abdomen, loss of appetite, weight loss, and polyphagia after meals. Imaging of stomach can be done through ultrasound, where we see the vollipo texture, stratified architecture, distension, focal growth, reduction, peristalsis. On radiography, we can see the various pre-gas, gasification, calculi, and the various mucosal contours and endolymphatic growths can be seen through use of barium salts to various concentrations and taking the image at various times and positions along the peristalsic passage of the contrast media. CT scan is the preferred imaging modality for assessing gastric pathology, where we can see both the luminal and extraluminal spread of disease. We can see the virtual endoscopy. Magnetic resonance imaging is also a good modality for because of its better soft tissue resolution as compared to CT. PET imaging is still under debate, but it can be used to detect metastatic deposits and the mechanisms of various blood of stomach. In our study, we shall be evaluating various forms of imaging of stomach pathology and shall be comparing it with endoscopy and operative findings and clinical follow up. The study was done on 25 patients, and the patients were complained of suspected gastric pathology, and the patient having gastric surgery or gastroenteritis or denying consent were not included. All the patients were subjected to ultrasonography, and then the CT scan radiography was done as and when applicable, and the final imaging were compared with endoscopy, post op findings, and the surgical follow-up. Now coming to the cases, the first case is of a 28-day-old male baby presenting with abdominal distension, and thickened on ultrasound we got thickened pylorus with 4.2 mm of diameter, and the pyloric canal was of 16 mm. The patient was taken up for high impact pyloroplasty, and the diagnosis was of congenital hypertrophic pyloestasis. This is a very classic case. The second case is a bit rare. A 6-day female patient with tense abdominal distension and non-violent vomiting. Ultrasound showed a non-demonstrable lumen of the pylorus. Barium meal showed a single bubble sign and gastrus abdomen, and the patient was of pyloric ascites. A 35-year-old female patient with dyspepsia and loss of appetite, and the ultrasound showed multiple polypoidal mucosal growths with increased towards pylorus. The patient suddenly increased in obstructive symptoms, and the patient was taken to gastrointestinostomy. And on surgery, the pylorus was thickened and not dry, and the biopsy showed intermittent polyps of the stomach. A 40-year-old male patient with on and off intake of NSAID, present with metamesis, and on endoscopy, a small bulge was seen on the body. Ultrasound showed a small hypoperfusion, and biopsy showed mucosal cells and mucosal cells, and the diagnosis was of lymphoma of the stomach wall. 6-year-old female patient presented with abdominal distension and non-bilious vomiting. The pyloric canal was narrowed on ultrasound, and however, the one thing was normal. The X-ray showed sharp cutoff of pylorus, and on surgery, the patient was diagnosed with acquired non-hypertrophic pyloric sclerosis. Now, coming to the next case. A 49-year-old female patient with complex of dyspepsia and reflux symptoms. Ultrasound showed a hypoperfusion near the gastrointestinal junction, and on contrast, we also showed a small round filling defect. Mucosal cells with minimal infiltrate was found on biopsy, and the diagnosis was of a mucosal polyp. Apathetic cone, a 40-year-old man with history of tumescent acid intake, gave, and on ultrasound, there was a distended stomach with thickened pylorus, and on surgery, mucosal erosion with thickened form pylorus was seen, and the diagnosis was of porosive stricture of pylorus. Coming to the next case, a 46-year-old female patient presented with prominent weight loss and loss of appetite. Ultrasound showed a thickened hypoechoic wall with loss of normal leiotico texture. CT showed a focal area of thick enhancing greater curvature, and endoscopy showed firm stomach walls, and the diagnosis was moderately differentiated and adenocarcinoma of the greater curvature. Coming to the next case, the 47-year-old man presented with profound weight loss and reduced appetite, and showed a thickened wall with loss, ultrasound showed thickened wall with loss of normal architecture, and hypoechoic lesions are seen in the liver, which is in the right lobe. CT scan showed thick enhancement of a non-distensible stomach. Endoscopy showed firm stomach walls with dysplastic mucosa and polypoidal growth. The diagnosis was of fully differentiated adenocarcinoma like the lanatus plastica type. 55-year-old male patient, presented with significant weight loss and distended abdomen. Ultrasound showed distended stomach with thickened pyloric walls, a perigastric lymph node with loss of fat weight was seen. And CT scan showed enhancing mastication in the pylorus with fuzzy margins. And the endoscopy showed, endoscopy directed biopsy showed a moderate differentiated adenocarcinoma. And this patient actually presented with gastric outlet obstruction and metastatic lymph nodes. Coming to the next case, a 72-year-old male patient presented with lump sensation in the upper abdomen. On ultrasound, a grossly thickened stomach wall was seen with maximum diameter of 33 mm and with loss of fat mass with liver. CT scan showed grossly thickened stomach wall with loss of fat mass with liver and pancreas. Endoscope showed thick edematous mucosal folds and the diagnosis was a non-Hodgkin lymphoma. A 69-year-old male patient presented with occasional fever and early satiety. Ultrasound showed a thick homogeneous hypoxic thickening of stomach wall. CT scan showed homogeneous enhancing stomach wall with maximum wall diameter of 44 mm. Endoscopy showed a tubulated mass distillate surface of the stomach mucosa and the diagnosis was of Hodgkin lymphoma. The study was of 25 patients with the maximum age group of 50 to 60 years, that is approximately 36%. The main symptom was of pain abdomen followed by vomiting and weight loss. The most common clinical findings were of lump abdomen, with the most common lump being seen in the left upper quadrant. The body was the most common site of lesion, and it was mostly of malignant etiologies. The cutoff taken for the study for malignant study was 7 mm, and all the lesions with thickness more than 7 mm were malignant, except for one case of the thoracic stricture of stomach after acid intake, which was of 7.7 mm. And so, coming to the conclusion, transabdominal sonography is a relatively harmless, readily available, first line imaging modality, having great potential in diagnosis of stomach diseases through proper assessment of oligotexture, stratified architecture, focal growths, reduction in peristalsis. Radiography can be also used as a first line investigation. However, we can see only the mucosal distortion. Extraluminal or metastatic scan not be commented upon. CT scan gives the accurate location of the lesion, luminal and extraluminal movement for better assessment of lymph node station, and with the help of negative molar contrast and IV contrast, multi-layer reconstruction can be done. This being said, we should always keep in mind the relevant history and use the age appropriate and case appropriate imaging modality for suggesting the diagnosis promptly in view of better patient management. Thank you so much.